Senator Rick Scott spent part of his day in Charlotte County to get a firsthand look at the devastation there. He visited businesses in downtown Punta Gorda hit hard by Helene's floodwaters. Senator Scott called the storm surge damage in that area unprecedented. Wake News reporter Amy Gallo was there with the senator, but also spent part of her day in Port Charlotte, and she spoke to a couple as they try to bounce back. And how, Amy, are they going to do that and get back to normal?
They told me they're taking it day by day. Right now, it's all about cleaning up, saving what can be saved, and tossing whatever can't, that number being a heck of a lot larger. Wesley and Karen Wingate will never forget what they had for dinner September 27th and what happened next.
We were having dinner and the water started to rise, and it was the same as the last storm.
So they didn't worry about it, carried on.
So once it came into the lanai, it got right up to the running boards of the door, right, the door jam, and I told my wife, I said, Karen, start picking stuff up off the floor. And within minutes, the water was about 6 inches in the house.
When all was said and done, Hurricane Helene brought about 2 feet of water inside their home.
When we opened the front door, the surge of water came in like a river, and so by then, it was over 4 feet from our driveway to the driveway across the street.
Luckily, their neighbors across the street own an Airbnb.
Nobody was there, so she was gracious enough to let us stay there. If we didn't have that place to go, we couldn't have got out of here. The water was so deep.
As for Wesley and Karen's belongings, they sit here on the curb.
We've lost all appliances, washer, dryer. Everything from Q-tips to the hot water heater is gone.
The floor will need replacing, as well as the drywall.
Everybody got caught off guard. It was just a monster in disguise, this storm.
But this couple isn't letting it bring them down.
This has been a harrowing experience, but God has poured down more blessings on us than we can count or even write down.
Karen told me this neighborhood has really come together during their time of need, helping each other out wherever they can. She said just yesterday, Peace River Botanicals was out here handing out food and water to anybody who needed them. Live in Port Charlotte, Amy Gallo, Wink News.